In part two of this field story interlude, Marisela Gutierrez, executive director of Siren, discusses how the Flexible Leadership Awards program, funded by the Evelyn and Walter Haas Jr. Fund, has helped her build the leadership and infrastructure of her organization. Rachel Baker, director of learning and field building at the Haas Leadership Initiatives, joins the conversation to share ways funders can best support the talent needs of their grantees.
And for us, it was really clear that the administrative infrastructure and operations of the organization was never invested. So the ED did a lot of the work. And that was my first year. I was HR, fund development. I didn't have a development director. I didn't have associate director, payroll. So my aunt also lead organiz you know, Siren as the ED and via things like this. And there's no way that I would burn out. I actually will burn out if I continue at that pace. So really thinking about, you need a development director, you need an associate director, you need an executive assistant, you know, things like that, that really basic grassroots organizations don't are not able to invest because of funding, or we're not thinking about the strategy to really build organizations in that way for the long-term sustainability of the organization.
So how were you able to build trust once you actually met the plan consultant and you started your work together so that you could have really candid conversations and that you could really help figure out where the funding would be most effective to help you and to help Siren?
I really saw an effort from the consultant to try and spend time with me in person versus phone call. A lot of the consultants that I talked to wanted to do a lot of their consulting via phone, but in person is so critical. And what I really appreciate about our consultant is that she never really gives me the answer. So she's always asking me, like, what do you think? Or what is the best way? And you know, and we talk about options. And I mean, she's really pushing me to come up with what is the best for organization. And she's also been the convener of building trust with all the teams. So she actually met individually with every single team member within the organization and also met with the board. So she really felt that that was critical to build trust not only with myself but also the larger representation of the organization. And I think that she almost feels almost like a team member of Siren, and people know they'll call her, and it doesn't have to be me calling her all the time, but she checks in with different senior level team members, the board president, and so we're always kind of in sync with one another.
So I just wanted to ask if you had just kind of any, because I know Maricela, you've already done this, about any kind of guidance or advice for funders. I'd like to ask Rachel to share kind of any guidance or things to think about for funders before we open it up for Q&A.
So one of them is, and I think, is it Anne Maria? Anne Marie? Is that your name? I
Yes.
think you were raising this question about, like, what are the parameters? How do you decide what funding gets used for, what you're offering? And I think the issue yesterday of how do we keep funders from being prescriptive or insensitive or even ignorant about what would be supportive to an organization. So one of the ways we do that is we make our funding flexible, and we give the organization the chance to decide how to tailor and use that funding. But on the other hand, we're not just responsive. And so, like, the other part of the tension on that, I think, is how can you guide an organization and help them think through the sequencing and help them think through the options and help them know about things that they might not have thought of? So I think that's a bit of a tension between being flexible and tailored, but not just being responsive and saying, like, here's the money if you want it, but also providing guidance and as sort of a thought partner along the way. So that's one tension. I think another one is this thing about individuals, investing in individuals, and also investing in how people work together, like teams. So a lot of our coaching is for individuals. You can use the funding for coaching for individuals, but also coaching for, like, the senior team or work for the board as a group. And I do think it's important for funders to consider how we can invest in individuals and for us to consider how we can help groups work together. And then that even goes above the organizational level, so the whole issue of networks. And Maricela was in the Fellowship for New California, which is, you know, working to build stronger relationships across immigrant rights organizations in California. So that individual, groups of individuals, sort of networks and systems of individuals is another creative sort of tension. And the last one is, I think, this part about where investing in leadership in a way that's in context of the work, like on the day-to-day job, like what do you need right now at Siren? How can we support you at work or your senior team? But also an opportunity to step out of the day-to-day and be able to find space to reflect about your purpose. And I think they're both valuable. And so insofar as we can all invest, or either we maybe not each do it within our organization, but how can we kind of collectively make sure that we're giving talent and leaders the opportunity to grow in the context of their work and also to step out of their work? Those are sort of three tensions. Well, one of the drawbacks is that it's somewhat resource intensive, and that has to do partly with it's almost a sort of halfway an operating program of the fund. And so if you go back to the bake it in thing, there's the fund's commitment to immigrant rights, and then we have a program officer who leads the immigrant rights strategy and makes sort of the decisions about what organizations to invest in. So that's like one link. And then we have the people in the Haas Leadership Initiative, so we're a program in the foundation. And then we work with the plan consultants who are external to the fund and are consultants. And then they work with Marisela and other leaders. So it is a chain, right? And that means when you have a chain like that, there's a lot of work goes into sort of making sure that people understand how everything connects and keeping in communication. And I think that there's a certain cost involved to doing it that way. But we also feel like that provides the space for Marisela to know that she can have a confidential conversation with Mari that we're not necessarily going to know about, but for Mari to understand what the fund is trying to, she's the PC, what the fund is trying to accomplish so that she can be an interlocutor. So I think resource intensive is one of the things in tension.
Yeah.